professional organization, which we, I hope we are, we need to have a communication strategy or just define how we're going to be sharing information, communicating as a group. So I try to summarize. This is based on the Charge and Prince 2 methodology, which I use a lot in terms of project management. So that's what the strategy will cover, really. We need to identify ways to responsibility, communicate, is it the leadership, is it members? Each one of us has got a responsibility really to communicate any useful information which will help the organization grow. So we've got this responsibility we have mentioned there, objectives of the communication. You know, are we just communicating for the sake of communicating? You know, now with social media, we can just throw things around. Communication procedure, again, we have to define what is acceptable as an official or formal communication mechanism. Tools and techniques, records and documentation. I think for farming, that's one thing we should emphasize more. Documentation is very important, record keeping. You know, if you are going to be doing farming, you need to know how you perform this year, and then you can compare with next year. You need everything documented and written down. So that's part of the communication, and that's the information you can then share as a group. The reporting structure as well, we've got groups like clusters, where you have the secretariat and the directors. Again, we need to understand that we don't kind of step on each other's toes or do things improperly. The timing of communication as well, we find that if we are going to farming seriously, engage in production now, the frequency of communication we have to increase the certain periods of the season. I mentioned roles and responsibilities there. Stakeholder analysis, who is a stakeholder? So like Prince 2, you have to identify who needs the communication, who needs the information. We've got the government, we've got the farmers that we mentioned, we've got members, everyone, one involved needs to have access and be with the information. So we need to understand who we are communicating with. Communication plan, really, it covers, it defines the parties interested and information required. So just putting that typical, you know, in Zimbabwe, they talk about, oh, that's Mbari, my tomatoes, my press, I got dingu. That's information, that's communication that you need. So if you are preparing your tomatoes for the market, then you need to know where you're taking them, what's the price like. That shows you how communication is going to be key. You can go there and sell your produce for the summer, really, if you're not careful. We're going to, where do you get the information from? They who is providing the information? We need to know if it's inputs, if we're going to grow maize or horticulture, who are the sources of the raw materials that we need for the inputs. The frequency, again, as I said, it's very important to know how often we should be communicating. If you're going to Zimbabwe in office, then those people need to know our expectations in terms of how they should be reporting regularly, that we are all kept abreast of the developments and the progress on the farms. Communication method. There are various methods that I'll touch on now, but I think email is much more professional. I think we know those ways that sometimes you want to tell someone something to a colleague and they say, oh, put it on email. Of course, they know that's official. It can be kept as a permanent record. It can be referred to later on. It's also authentic. So that's why I prefer that. If it's something that is very important, something which you feel that it will help the organization, it should be put down on email. Yes, you've got WhatsApp groups and other platforms, but we need to be mindful with the media that you are using to communicate. This is just a diagram to show the process of communicating. We will get noise, obviously, which is information that is really not necessary, just coming through the channels, but we need to be able to decipher and know what information is critical to our operations. Email, website, we've got a website which we need to kind of revamp or make it much more dynamic and link on to other plugins or other sources of information. Someone mentioned using it as a marketing tool as well. But that's if we know the traffic. One thing we need to do, it's okay having a website there which is just sitting, just a presence, but then it's another thing making sure it's doing the work, which is you're getting the traffic, you're getting hits, you're getting people visiting it. And then you also then need to know what sort of people are visiting your website so that you can put up information which is required and not something which is not relevant. I will try and combine a central database, which consists of information about all the members, all the stakeholders, that is like suppliers in Zimbabwe, or any other people like If you are going farming, you need inputs to maintain the implements. If you are going to implement at the moment, you need to identify sources where you can go and get a tractor. You can go and get a planter or combine harvest. So such a database will provide that resource for us to get the information. I just went on to explain more about email there. Medium of choice, that's what I would recommend we use as an organization. Form our reliable audit trail. You can always see where it came from. I know there's lots of spam as well, but we need to make sure we've got some authenticity in our communication. So we can have a ZAI identity by getting our own email domain. So you may continue using, I know you don't want to let go of your Hotmail and Yahoo email accounts, but we can have a link to ZAI so that you can just save forward us. You use the ZAI email address, but then the email comes to your Gmail or Hotmail. But we need to have some identity. So email coming from Mr. Nira should be saying maybe gnira@zai.org, something like that. That's something we need to build as we try and get ourselves an image, professional image. So yeah, the emails will be used for things like reminding members when you need to pay your membership at the end of the year. Then the email can also be used to generate automatic reminders for all of us. Website, as I said, the advantage is the wider audience, you can access it, but we can also use it. I know we've been talking about showcasing a lot, isn't it? So the website can also be used to show what you're doing. This is a potato crop there which I put up. It can be accessible anytime, really, 24/7. You can have plugins. Plugins will give information on weather. If you know, sometimes you go on the BBC website, you can see what the weather's like in the area today. That's some of the things that we would hope to put on our website, that you can see if you are doing farming in concession, then you can see what the weather is like. You can see maybe if it has been raining today. You don't have to wait to make a phone call to Zimbabwe to get that information. So good fees that can come in, like commodity prices, as I said before, prices of current market prices of commodities. You can find out from the website if you are linked to various databases that provide that information. You can also see the resourcing element as well, where you can buy your inputs or access implements for plowing or planting. Social media, there you go. Showcasing. I hope I'm making you feel more happy then. But that's someone showing it on food. That's quite a lot of food there. So yeah, this is just the part of our keto health. So you can just show what you're doing, show others, and they can see. And then you can start talking and saying, where can I go and see that? How are you doing it? So this is why what social media is all about. We can talk of having our own maybe YouTube channel. We can do that if people are seriously into this and want to share information. I know there's Facebook, Twitter, there's a Facebook presence already. Which again, we need to do more in terms of making it much more useful too, rather than just put it out there. Snapchat, I think those who like pictures will enjoy that. Instagram, when you go out to your farm, just kind of real time, send in those pictures, send in those video clips so people can see what they're doing.
Sorry. And to add on to that, we can, like you mentioned the YouTube channel, we can add videos on like how to type of videos. Which can help, individual members on, knowledge sharing in terms of doing certain activities.
Yeah, so they can be very useful tools. I know we don't find them in instance or probably too that they're just for leisure, but it can be used for business purposes. So also you can use to monitor your projects in Zimbabwe. We can ask those guys, if you keep them with the smartphones and they got the 3G or internet access, they can take a picture and send you, short video, send you. You can see here, yeah, it's like you've been to your farm when you're actually over this side.
CCTV,
if you've got the broadband, good broadband connection, then yeah, you can actually go on the internet, log on and see what's happening in real time.
Just make sure they're not showing you the neighbor's farm.
Yeah, that's true. I know some people have really tended to stop by the roadside and start taking pictures of other people's
problems. This level of technology, about CCTV. It will be installed at your farm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then you can access it right now. It will just ping on there. You can have a look at what's going on. Even in terms of cattle feed, chicken feed, you can as well check if the chicken has been fed. You can check if the water has been given. So it will tell you.
Yeah. But just watch out for those garden boys. They will be very, very miffed. They will think what's happening. Is this some kind of juju? How can you tell? How can you see that I'm not at the farm? So, but yeah, these are very useful tools. So we can also use it to reach out potential members. You know, people go onto YouTube. If you find a way of making yourself easily visible, you can probably, from the searches that people do on YouTube, something comes up and they become aware of ZAI. So that's another tool you can use for publicity as well. But the way forward in terms of communication, as I said, I'd like to combine kind of send our database each member's details and also other important resources like where we can get the inputs, the prices, the markets, and other things as well. So location of operations, as I said, we can then tell, for example, if someone wants to do a certain crop in certain areas, we know the types of soils that are there and we know maybe the rainfall patterns. So we need to have that information which will inform us or enable us to make informed decisions in terms of what crops or what sort of agriculture activities we engage in. Alright, that's me. We're finished there. So communication is vital. I say it's like large in our bodies. If you miss communication, then you just get you're dead. You die for it. So we want to make sure we keep it flowing. Everyone communicates and information is shared timely. And there's times of communication there where it's headed at the vertical. That's when you're talking to leadership. And that's why when you talk amongst ourselves in our groups as well, let's communicate not just through the leadership, but even amongst ourselves as members.